Okay, again, it's the same example. We put the salary to zero. So we have this instruction which takes place. After after this instruction, we have a trigger which will try to repair it. And when we will see it, we have two tables, the inserted, okay, which are in fact the rows concerned, but after the modification, so we see that the salary is zero because after the modification, and the deleted, which were the row that are removed, okay? So what happens if we have this row here that we remove, we put them there, oops, they are modified, and we put this new ones in the table, okay? So we are going to see how we use it in a full example of a trigger soon. Okay, we will see a little bit later. So most of the time, what we are going to do in these exercises is we have a trigger which see, okay, here we have a problem, we put the salary to zero. When someone tries to do an insert and put the salary to zero, we cannot really repair it. We have no idea what should be the real value. We cannot guess the salary of these people. So we will generally abort it, okay? And it will just undo all the bad instruction. If we know how to repair it, okay? For instance, if you say that all the employees of the same lab must have the same salary, then when we modify someone and we change his lab, we could know what is his salary, then we can repair, and then we are going to re-update the database to put it again into a coherent state. So voilà, here we are going to do an example. So we have these databases with two tables. The employee table, okay, different employees which are in different departments. And we say that it's a policy from the company. An employee cannot have a larger salary than his manager. Okay, so an employee is in a department. Each department has a manager which is itself an employee. So we can know for each employee who is his manager. And we should be sure that the salary of an employee is not larger than the one of its manager. So what could be wrong? How could we broke this rule, okay? So here, the first step when you have this kind of exercise where you want to ensure some stuff, here we want to ensure the blue part, the salary of employee lower. We are first going to have to check what can be all the bad cases. A bad case is, for instance, I will add a new employee. If I add a new employee, I give him a department which automatically assign him a manager. If at the moment of insert I put him a too high salary, I will break this rule. So this is the first event that could happen. There are some other events. I could just modify an employee and either increase its salary and then he's getting more than his manager. Or if he's himself a manager, if I decrease its salary, it could also violate it. And there are two more events, either when we change an employee from department, okay, or when we change the manager of a department. These are all the cases where we can break our rule, so we are going to do more or less one trigger for each case. Sometimes, like the two first, we can do one trigger which takes both the cases together, but sometimes we will need more triggers for all the different cases. So here we have an example for the first cases. So here we are going to prevent that when we add a new employee, we could break the relation. So how are we going to do it? We create a trigger, we give it a name. Okay, we are going to work on the table employee. The event that we are covering is the insert event when we insert a new employee. And here, so we put all our call. Okay, that is the part, the SQL statement. And what are we going to do? We start by an if, okay. If exists, it's typical, we are going to check if there is something which breaks our rule, okay, then we abort, we undo all the modifications. So what happens here? So we are going to check all the employees that we've inserted, which are in the special table inserted that you have seen, okay. For all these employees inserted, since it's a trigger on the employee table, it has the same structure as the employee table. So for all the inserted, you are going to find their departments, okay? Thanks to their departments, you can find their manager, and you are going to check, is the manager salary smaller than the inserted employee salary, okay? If you find one case where the manager's salary is smaller than the employee, then this if will be true, and then we will execute this code. So if you find one case where the rule is broken, then we will roll back and do all the modifications. Okay, is it clear for everyone? Yes.
What is the inserted table? Inserted table, is there any inserted table?
Yeah. So this is a bit like this case. So if we do an update on the table employee, okay, we will have a table which is called inserted, which has the same structure as employee, so SSN lab salary, and deleted. They are in fact employees. And the inserted are the new values that you have put in the database after this instruction. When we do these instructions, these two lines are removed, so we put them in deleted, and they are replaced by these two lines, so they are in the inserted. Did it answer your question or not?
I mean, will it be inherent? I mean, explicitly created or inherently created?
It is created by behind
by the system.
By the system, yes. You don't have to create them. It's when you do a trigger, these tables are created and they exist, and you can use them. You don't need to create them. They are created by the database engine. Yes.
Are these tables also created when you do an instead of insert of an actor?
Yes, normally yes. Okay, so normally here we have all that you need to know to do the exercises. You will always have some rules like this rule. The first step to do is to check all the possible events, and then for each event do a trigger, or sometimes one trigger for different events. So since you most of you have the ID, it's okay. Yes, if you want to work on this computer room, so I should have said it maybe before, but you need to boot on Windows to be able to have the correct application. So if you started the computer on Linux, please restart it with Windows. And this is the name of the server where you connect.
I think you're on Linux.
If you work on in the computer rooms, you will all access the same server. So just to be sure that you have your own database, when you create a database, add your net ID inside so that you don't both work and make some changes on your neighbor's database. Okay, this is for everyone on the website. There are some scripts to create the database and to load it. Okay, and once it's loaded, you can do the exercises. This we said. And the last detail, it happens a lot. This is an old print screen, but it's from SQL Manager server, something like this, the app. You have two ways of deciding on which database you work, because with SQL Server you have a lot of databases. So either you see it here, you select it, or in your script you just select it. And don't forget to do it, because it's a mistake that happens to a lot of students. Okay. I don't know if it's okay for everyone. I can show you here quickly how to load the scripts. I don't know if it's, or if normally you should be able to do it yourself, but. Did everyone succeed or to load the database already? Or maybe I will let you 10 minutes to do it, and if you have problems, I can come and help you. Yes?
Create the
Yeah.
Custom
Let's.
Okay, I'll pass that.